ஆகிய பிரகாசமும் அம்ஜன் ஆல்வேஸ் அல்லா சுபான் அண்ட் பிளீசிங் பிளஸிங் அப்பான் அவர் ப்ராஃபிட் மொபைல் சல்லாஹ் அலைஹி வஸல்லம் அண்ட் இஸ் கம்பெனியன் அண்ட் ஜஸ்ட் மூவர் கேட்டர் இன் திஸ் ப்ரோக்ராம் அல்ஹம்துலில்லாஹ். டுடே ஐ வுட் லைக் டு ஸ்பீக் அபவுட் பிலால் த கிரேட் ஆஃப்ரிக்கன் முஸ்லீம். பிலால் அலியல்லா இஸ் வெரி லவ்லி ரிமெம்பர் பை ஆல் முஸ்லீம் ஆஃப் த வேர்ல்ட் ஹாஸ் ஒன் ஆஃப் த அர்லியஸ்ட் கிரேட் ஆஃப்ரிக்கன் முஸ்லீம். He was born in a village in a mountainous place in Western Arabia. Bilal Aliyah's father was called Reba and his mother was known as Hamama. The father and mother were slaves of Umayya bin Khalaf, a rich man from the tribe of Quraysh. Bilal Aliyah was therefore born in slavery and served as a housekeeper. His master Umayya bin Khalaf was not a Muslim. When Bilal Aliyah was about the age of 40, it was the time when Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam started teaching a new religion of Islam. Bilal Aliyah was attracted by the teaching of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He accepted the religion of Islam and became a Muslim. When Umayya bin Khalaf and his family went to worship idols, Bilal Aliyah would pray to Allah as taught by Islam. In the earlier days of Islam, the tribe of Quraysh, who were strong and many and liking and around Makkah, disliking Islam. They also disliked Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his new teaching. If any one person accept the new religion, they harassed him. When the Umayya bin Khalaf came to know of Bilal Aliyah's secret prayers, he called Bilal Aliyah and asked, "Who Bilal, do you worship and bow down to the God of Muhammad?" Bilal Aliyah was not afraid. He replied, "Yes, Master, I do worship Allah, the only God." The reply angered Umayya greatly. He began to torture Bilal Aliyah. He was tied with rope and made to lie on a burning hot desert. He was then asked to forget the God of Islam and worship the great idols known as Lot and Uzza. But Bilal Aliyah was strong in his new belief. He refused to worship idols and kept crying Ahadun Ahad, meaning one God, one God. The torture continued and were increased. Hot iron rods were stamped on his pain body. All through his life, Bilal Aliyah remained a close companion of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and was with him at very occasion. When the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam died, he was very sad, and thereafter all his life he looked grave and very solemn. He had gone to Medina when the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had migrated. After the death of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he did not feel happy to stay in Medina. He had sadly discontinued his adhan and migrated to Syria. People still go to his grave to pay respect and salute him. We are also salute to Bilal Aliyah, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.